Welcome back to Banner Saga. There are certain things I can buy from the market. Attacks never deflected. Yeah, sure, that's useful. I will not deny that. By the way, units need a certain level to be able to use certain items. Like if I got this, if I got these two items, for instance, I would need level 4 units, which I do not have. Also, they would cost more renown than I currently have right now. I can buy some supplies from the market. That's kind of stupid, but whatever. I'm gonna get the iron band. It's okay. Because why the fuck not? And I'm gonna put that on Ivor at the moment. Because he is my most powerful fighter. He's a Varl after all. Anyway, let's go talk with the chieftain. Rook, thank the gods you made it. The Grey Hall is another den, filled as it is with dozens of terrified families. Don't stop worrying yet. I haven't. What in the depths is going on? Dredge milling around, ransacking houses. The chieftain's wife finds you, pushing through the crowd. They must know we're here. Why haven't they attacked? Don't know. I wouldn't expect it to last. I've made some decisions, but tell me straight, what would you both do in my place? I'd have left by now. They're already outside doors. Not so easily done. Rook? I trust Ivor on this. The chieftain sighs a deep and heavy breath, slumping. He looks years older. I imagined us fighting back and saving the town, but nonsense. Ivor's right, of course. We can't just wait to be slaughtered. Where do we go? If the dredge are coming down from the north, Frostfeller, to the west. It's close and it has walls. I intend to be free of Skogr in one push. Nobody left behind. I wouldn't. If they follow us, we're done here. What do you suggest? Let me create the distraction, then go. I'll catch up on the road to Frostfall. Do we abandon the storehouse? If we have to, we'd be leaving behind everything but the supplies you brought, Rook. On the other hand, Frostfeller is at least a week away. I'm not sure we've got that much food. It'll be cutting it close. If we're saddled with heavy carts, it'll be almost impossible to outpace the dredge. And if we run out of food before we get to Frostfeller, it won't matter how many escape. I still say let me handle the dredge. No, you need those supplies. You have a very limited amount of supplies, and you're gonna fight for a lot of enemies anyway. You're gonna lose some clansmen and some fighters as a result of this decision if you decide to take it. I haven't seen the other two outcomes, so I don't know what happens there, but anyway, we can't afford to leave the food behind. It's going to get us killed, Rook. Die fighting dredge or starve on the road. I'd rather fight. I agree with Rook. Then I'm coming with you. That catches you by surprise. The chieftain rubs his chin but doesn't argue. From the training she's given Alet, you've no doubt she can handle a bow. Fine, I'll get the townspeople ready. Take some fighters and gather as much food as you can. Tell us when you're ready. Right, let's get the food. Get the food. It's not gonna be an easy fight. You step into the courtyard where you can already see dredge in every direction. The storehouse isn't far. You slip inside and start loading carts while Ivor and the half dozen men who came along do the same. When you've gathered as much as you dare, Ivor takes position outside the great hall. Dredge have already taken notice, watching closely. Come on, he mutters, and people begin filing out the hall. Almost immediately, things begin to go wrong. Some dredge go after the ox, like supplies, while others launch at the cart with chickens. Terrified men, axes, and the dredge responding behind. Not far away, you spot Ivor raising his shield, cursing to prepare for a fight. Alright, let's begin. Of course, this one's not gonna be an easy thing. So, I have quite a lot of tough enemies, actually. These two right here. What the fuck is up with my HP? Right? Just stops showing itself whenever I close the game for whatever reason. Or whenever I reload the save. Okay. Right. This. So the first one to move. Obviously don't want to block right. So that's the first one that's gonna make a move. And move her over here. Yes, I'm gonna use Stone Wall right here. It should help him survive some hits from my enemies. Deflect chance is quite high in that, but yes, that worked out very well for me. Well, that's actually gonna work very well for me. Yes. I'm gonna move Eagle right here to block their path even further. I'm gonna move my archers. If I can, well, that's pretty fucking awesome for me. Except I have to now use ranged units to be able to support Eagle. Anyway, Ivor should be able to finish off this dredge. Scourge. Now, here's the thing. When he does that, he's gonna be summoning reinforcements. You obviously want to finish him off. Though in this particular case, I'm actually gonna move Ivor right here and do damage to him. Because I still have enough turns for... until the dredge makes his move. Alright, he's gonna do some damage because he's... Alright. Yeah, two damage. And Ivor will damage this one. What the? been promoted, very good. I don't want to lose her. I might... don't have anything... but hope. Miss. Or that. Okay, free damage. Good. Shit. Give me a miss, you son of a bitch. Well, it's not much, but... fuck! Son of a... I'm really pissed off by that, actually. I'm really, really pissed off. Anyway. Ah, son of a bitch. Yeah, I apologize. I know some people are gonna be very pissed off. Oh, you reload. God forbid someone actually screws up in a fucking walkthrough. And I did screw up. So just skipping past the dialogue. Seeing failure is just as important as seeing success. In my opinion. Anyway, let's see here. That fight is just piece of shit in many ways, actually. It's like, oh yeah, let's give you two champions to fight. You can get an easier one if you don't level up your characters, so easier is up for grabs, really. In this particular situation, so... first one is gonna move as that guy. Let me just hit him with 2 damage. And move Ivor right there. Hit him more. I wonder. If I move a lit, right here, I guess, right? I'm gonna use a lit to hit him. Do some damage. Let's use Stonewall. Good. And who's next? Okay. Right, that guy's next. And after that, this guy, and then that guy. Okay, I have enough turns to do. Alright. We need to reduce their armor. Okay, to get the resist. Six damage, good. Good. Well, I have enough turns to deal with the giant and the elephant in the room. Well, the two elephants, but one of them has been hit somewhat hard. Well, that's not a very good position for him to be in, right? Come on. Alright, 2 damage. And with Rook, I should be able to finish him off. There we go. Well, not finishing him off, but it's gonna cause him to switch to that. And when he does that, what he's doing right there is summoning reinforcements. Now, this is not the wisest of moves, but... do 3 damage. Survivor dies, that's... that's annoying, but not unexpected. If I don't deal with this guy, he's gonna just get some reinforcement, so... there we go. I'm gonna move Ivor far, far back. I can ooh, that was a nice combo. I'm hoping that'll go after him. Well, that didn't happen. Yes, go ahead, hit him. You're not accomplishing anything. By the way, in terms of wounded, characters can't die, but they can be wounded. Well, certain characters can die if you lose certain battles, specific battles, or just battles overall in a specific chapter of the game. Alright, that's 2 damage. Shield activated. What the? Are they bugged out or something? I don't know, I don't care. Very well, if they're not gonna do their turns, who am I to complain? You go, Rook. Moving a lead to get it on him. To roll power. It should be enough to lower his, well, I guess I'm gonna have to deal with the reinforcement one time. I have faced worse, so why not? Free damage. Where is that? Ah, there we go. Ah, shit. Hmm. Well, Adley should kill him. His promotion. And a promotion for Rook. Eagle will move in the next one and soak whatever may come his way. I'm gonna use Rook to do a bunch of damage. Yeah, 4 damage. Very well. Thankfully, I didn't get her killed. Son of a bitch. What the chance, what the time to get the deflect, right? I'm gonna get the, or try to get killed with that lead. Hopefully it will work. Yeah. Now it doesn't matter what kind of HP the you finish the battle with on your units, as long as they don't get incapacitated. They'll be healed full for the next one. If they get incapacitated, they'll be wounded for a number of days. For Varl, it's about 4 days, give or take. For humans, about 2 or 3 days. In the chaos that follows, you notice out of the corner of your eye some of the town guards struggling desperately with Dredge, and one might be the chieftain among them. To your left, Ivor is laying into a large colossus. Behind him, an elderly man scrambles to his feet. Past that, it's clear that most of the townspeople are scattering. If nobody steps in, they could be picked off one by one. Nearby, a ox bleeds pitifully as Dredge will wrestle with a wagon tied to it. Another full cart has been toppled beside it, abandoned. You could end up losing more food and supplies than you started out with. Well, need to get those supply carts. Without food, it doesn't matter how many people escape. Ivor, you shout, burying your axe into the nearest dredge. With a grunt, he joins you in fending off the dredge around the supplies. Right, so he's injured. Actually, that's a pretty fucking serious injury. 6 days. Yes, not pleasant. Anyway, that's very bad. Very fucking bad. Anyway, I'm going to move Eagle right here. I'll use Ivor to do armor damage. I don't know, it depends on what he can do better. Yeah. Yeah, it's archers, man. It's archers. Oh, well, I hate this job. Sometimes. Well, if Eagle survives. Alright. Oh. damage. Yeah, so let's hit him. 3 damage. There as well. My archers are so pathetic. Well, except Rook. Rook is about the only exception to their rule, though. That would happen, but this retaliation. Promoted once again. Let's see if I can get her promoted. It's not going to be easy though. 2 by 4. Right, I'm hoping he'll hit him. Yes, he did, exactly as I planned. Rook should be able to do quite a bit of damage on his own. I'm just hoping to delay the inevitable here. Proud. Yes. Yeah, it's not unexpected. Alright, this should be fine. I hope. I'm not blind though, I'm not in the best of positions. I can use a Rook's special ability though to do some extra damage to the bastards. But I can't actually, can I? Just 1 HP down. Tense fight, huh? Tense fight. Pillaged. I'll just take down his armor and use that leaf to take to finish him off. And that's it. And the battle is won. Renat has been gained. Well, and I've gained, and I've leveled up some people as well. Fighters notice your victory and scramble to help throw supplies back on the wagons. You gather what you can and get the ox moving. Soon you've put the distance between you and the dredge. Survivors gather as you flee fewer than you had hoped. You see Alif as she emerges from a row of trees, struggling to bear the body of the chieftain in her arms. Her face is blank. Helping her to the caravan, you cover the body with a cloth. The chieftain's death hits you like a punch to the gut. Only at Ivor's insistence does the caravan get moving again to Frostburg. Alette's hands clasp tightly around your own, and you walk together in silence. 15 renown. A bunch of supplies as well. Okay. First and foremost, level up. Now, on her, this is what I'm gonna do. On him, well, you want to increase that armor rating because he's the most powerful fucking tank in the game. And on her, yes, exactly this. On Rook, wait. No, I can't think. Increase Ivor's rank, but I can increase Rook's. Alright, so this is... Wait, I didn't proper level... Oh, fucking hell. That's why Rook was so ineffective. It's like, why the hell is he so bad? It's like, well, you didn't level him up properly. It's like, well, I'm an idiot. Anyway, they'll recover before the next battle, and there is going to be a next battle soon enough. Egil. How's the arm, Egil? You find Egil just outside the camp, practicing his sword swings. I saw you taking some hard hits out there. Oh yeah, I'm great. Not great considering everything that's... I'm fine. My arm's fine. It's a strong shield. It's Rook, right? I know we haven't talked much before now. But if you want, just call me Gil. Okay, Gil. I wanted to let you know that I meant what I said before about make sure nothing happens to Alette. You're protective of Alette, huh? Well, she's... I don't want her to get hurt. You can see his cheeks turn bright red. Don't worry, she can take care of herself too. I know I didn't mean... Easy, girl. I know what you meant. Ivor seems to think you're pretty good. Did he say that? That's good. I'm trying. Never had to fight anything like the dredge before, but... I don't have much else to do. And how many people get to train with the Varl? Just seems like I could be of help to someone. That's what I want to be. I've never seen a shield like that before. Yeah, I doubt there's many. My father made this. It's solid metal, really heavy. But I've been practicing it with it since I was a kid. Bloody hell. Practicing with that since you were a kid? Yeah, sure. I used to spend a lot of time just getting used to lifting it. He raises it up to show you. I'm pretty good with it now. It's the only thing of my father's I have left. And when my mother died, she gave it to me before she died. Stay strong. Oh, and if you need something, let me know. I can do anything you need. Between you and Ivor, we're going to be okay, I can tell. Yeah. He can die at many points in the game, unfortunately. And, well, let's just say he will likely die. Anyway, Costin here on Serious Gaming signing out. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Thank you all for watching and stay tuned for more. There's a donation link in the description if you want to help out the channel. And also don't forget to check out my walkthroughs on Dailymotion as well.